listening to WESN, your rhythm of life. Hey folks, make Wednesday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time your favorite day to tune in to WESN for Mama Bear Tracy's show and let the good times roll. I will bring you some great music, great stories, interesting stories, and I will send positive vibes to power you through the week right here on WESN. Epic Strategies Network.
Do you want to listen to something cool, fresh, and become a cub? Hi, I'm Stewie Griffin, and I'm a longtime listener of the Mama Bear Tracy Show. And you can catch this amazing show, Donald.
Yes, when can we catch the show? Because I don't want to miss it.
Well, funny you should say, because you can catch it Wednesday at 1 p.m. Eastern Time.
In a WSN Strategy Network, I presume.
Yeah, how did you know?
Because I downloaded it and I listened to it too, Stewie. What a great show.
So everyone, if you'd like to listen to it, give it a go. You won't be disappointed. I promise. Honestly, would I lie for money? I don't know.
WESN, Epic Strategies at Network.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Lift off.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to the Ralph William Podcast. And if you're not down with that, we got two words for you.
Hey, does anybody want a coffee? Who wants coffee? I just made a fresh pile of cuts. Does anybody want coffee? Who wants cuts? Does anybody want coffee? Who wants coffee?
Having conversations about society, one cup at a time. Coffee with R.W.
Oh, cafecito.
Pour yourself a cup and join us.
Es un cafecito.
Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. This is your boy, Ralph William. Follow me on Twitter at Ralph William. Follow my internet station on Twitter as well, WESN Radio. Download our mobile app on your app store, Epic Strategies Network, and help support the station by joining our Patreon. Go to patreon.com/WESN Radio. If you have your coffee mugs, your travel mugs, your sippy cups, your doggy bowls, if you got a beer hat, you want to drink it like that, go ahead and do so. And join me in this sip of cafecito. Yeah. Anyway, sorry. It is hump day. We hope that you guys are very well hydrated and getting ready for the day. You're halfway down the week. We still got a couple more days to go. So let's get started. First off, I want to say hello to Mama Bear from the Mama Bear Tracy Show, which you can hear on WESN at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time today. What's up, Mama Bear?
Hi, Ralph William.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
How was your shower?
Good, thank you.
Refreshing? You feel clean?
Yeah.
Cool. We're also joined by our buddy from the West Coast, TQ. Hello, sir.
And can you hear me?
Good morning. Yes, sir. Good morning.
I didn't see my bubble light up.
It's all good.
I just read some horrible news right now.
Ooh, hold off on that. That's a good tease. Hold off on that. I want to welcome in Mr. James, Duke James from worldshopdj.square.site. Good morning, Mr. James.
Good morning, Ralphie. Good morning, Mama Bear. Brother Gang, ain't seen you in a while. How you doing? Still, sir? other than that, you know, back to the, you know,
shit. Back like, to the you know. Grizzly? Back to the yeah, grind man. Again? Back to
yeah.
the grind again.
Back gotcha. To the grind.
Speaking yep. of grind, the man who needs no introduction but gets one anyway, he might be yep. grind. He might grind at night. Who knows?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, I want to welcome you to the Ralph Williams Podcast with this big, humongous.
Stop.
Good morning, Steels.
It's hump day.
Oh, fuck yeah.
There goes that. I like the way that went together. I like that.
Oh, man. All right. First off, man, Steels, you sent me a video of some shenanigans happening at a Newark airport.
Oh, it was a Diddy party.
Was it? Oh, my God. Was it?
No.
It was who? Sexy Rose?
Sexy Red.
Red, I'm sorry.
Sexy Red. She is a big time current hip hop artist. Her album just came out or is coming out. I think it just came out or is coming out this week, something like that. She hosted WWE NXT's pay-per-view this past Sunday. But before she hosted it on Sunday, on Saturday at Newark Airport, from what we understand, she was on the plane and somebody took a picture of her and she didn't like the fact that they just took a picture of her because she wasn't informed, let's just put it that way. And she told the person on the plane, when we get off the plane, I'm gonna beat you. Wow. You know, and the fight started, and as you see, if you see the video, you see she picks up one of these big metal stands that we have and she goes to fling it, but somebody kind of pushes her out the way, and one of her I guess is either one of her security guards or one of her friends or whatever. Yeah, he kind of like pushes her out the way, and he's the one that gets really arrested. She did get arrested, but I'm guessing that she was let go right away because on Sunday she was at the pay-per-view as the host. So, you know, who knows? But yeah, man, it was very interesting. Very interesting.
Go sexy.
Let me see.
I'll post it on the Discord, TQ, so you can see it.
Round one.
Thank you, Steels.
So, I don't know if this is coming through. Hold on.
Bend that ass over. Let that coochie breathe. Shake that ass. Bend on your knees. Hey. Working at 707 was not on my bingo card this morning.
So that is one of her tracks.
Yeah, that's Sexy Red. Yeah.
Yeah, that's Sexy Red. Yeah.
I thought that would have been, yeah, she would cause any trouble.
Man. Bro, that shit is.
She is, listen, it's just to the fact that every hip hop station over here that plays her, okay? Says the same thing over and over and over. She is a big troll, you know. Yeah, like what?
Do you remember the girl from the Super Bowl? They said that was showing
Oh, the Illuminati sign?
Yeah, with the upside down cross and stuff.
Ice Spice.
No, that's Ice Spice. Two different. Two different.
I retract all my stupidity. No,
okay. Two different people.
I'm with you, Mr. A.
No, two different people.
I completely didn't know who she was, if that was her.
But going back to what I was saying, like, so all the hip hop stations over here, they, you know, they play Sexy Red and everything, but they all say that she's a troll in the industry, that she started just to troll somebody, and she just kind of blew up because people were listening to her, type thing.
The first time I heard,
like, troll, like, she was just like frogs are like gay, a troll type of stuff, like just messing with people in the industry,
like a trolling. Like, yeah, she was trolling. Like, she just decided, hey, I'm gonna do a song and, you know, troll people and make fun of this, and she wound up, people actually liked her, and she's making, she made a whole album and everything. It's called What is it?
No, I said, and now we're fucked. But you made an album. Can't get rid of it.
It's called, the album is called, oh my God, Run for President or Sexy Red for President, something like that.
Yeah. I thought it was like Hood Princess or some bullshit, but
that's I'm pretty sure it's like Sexy Red for President or something.
Say something stupid that went viral, and now she's rich to make the album.
See,
but I mean,
stop making talentless people famous.
People like stupid people. Yeah,
that's why you guys all love me.
Yeah.
Wait, what, Ralph?
There's no way to answer that. That's messed up. That's entrapment.
The only one that answered. That's messed up.
That's entrapment. Yo.
Did you?
It's a trap.
Yeah.
Shame. Yeah, I'm over here like,
wait, no.
Notice I stayed quiet this time.
Thank you, Steel. I even give you a little respect for that.
So, Ralph, I didn't show you the video, but she's twerking all over, and she actually got Shawn Michaels to twerk with her.
Yeah,
I think I saw that. I think I saw that on my For You page.
Shawn Michaels?
He was singing his song on the way to the fucking the venue, the Shawn Michaels intro song. She was singing that shit. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's...
I think I'm sexy.
She's a big wrestling fan. That's why they got her on NXT, because she's like really big on wrestling. Like, she tweets like almost every Tuesday about wrestling.
Isn't that special?
Well, at least she's not trolling about that. That she is, I hope she's.
That's what you call dedication.
Yeah, a lot of people, you know, I don't know if they know they're gonna be on a certain show or whatever. They prep themselves like, love your show. I know what you do. I know what you did 30 years ago. I'm like, sure.
Yeah, that's what everybody was thinking. Cause, like, you know, she was the host and whatever. So everybody was like, oh, she's, you know, she really doesn't watch wrestling, blah blah blah. But then she kind of like broke down a lot of facts, and everybody was like, oh, okay, maybe you do.
You think you can know? Just on the sidebar, you think?
Spit it out, Ralph.
You think someone would know? No, wait. The best way to know is someone's a true wrestling fan. If you was to ask them, like, do they know about the Montreal Screwjob?
I mean, no, you got to ask them like weird questions. Like,
what the hell's a Montreal?
Okay. Obviously,
and that's coming from a Canadian.
Thanks for proving my point wrong.
Prove my point wrong.
Well, one of the biggest
things to ever happen in wrestling, but, you know, it's all right.
Yeah, but I'd have to see it.
That's what she said.
Send it to me, Steelson, and I'll tell
it's
you.
It's when Shawn Michaels put the sharpshooter on Bret Hart, and the bell was rang before anything. Bret Hart really didn't tap out and everything like that. That's when Bret Hart was leaving WWE.
Oh, yeah.
She probably wasn't watching wrestling that much before.
I know very, 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 very little about wrestling.
Yeah, well, that's warranted. But if someone says, oh, I know everything about, I love wrestling or whatever. That's a good way to like test them. Like, oh yeah, what do you know about this?
But you know what? Yeah. When I was little, my father and brother used to watch.
That was a long time ago.
I know, right? They used to watch.
Was that Bruno Sammartino time?
Damn. That's true for like years.
Watch it out of the garage.
No, my dad and my brother would watch wrestling when I was really little.
That when I mean, you like
Attitude Era stuff. That's why. Like you like, you know.
I don't even know. She likes that. I don't even know when you started wrestling, Malver.
She likes Attitude. She likes The Rock. She likes Stone Cold. Oh, yeah. She likes Undertaker.
Who doesn't?
Yeah.
No, but I'm saying,
I liked Macho Man.
That's what I'm saying. She likes like late 90s to, you know, whatever.
And Elizabeth. I liked her. I felt bad.
Yeah. Yeah. I was going to say, she liked the, you know, she likes that. She's in that era that, you know, most people.
The big young era.
The wrestler of all times is Mankind.
Who?
I used to Mankind.
He said Mankind.
Oh yeah.
You remember? I used
to love him when he used to pull out Sako and make motherfuckers gag.
Yeah.
And another curse.
Yeah, this is done. This is Patreon right here. But the Lady Red though. What I keep
sexy
saying?
Red. Red. Sexy Red. Sexy Red.
Mm-hmm. Was she fighting like a dude? Like who took the picture of her?
You really can't tell in the video, but. It's like the guy that's in the video is kind of, like I said, her entourage or whatever. He's the one that gets arrested and everything like that. What's up, the Maven? But I honestly don't know if it was a female or a guy or whatever. But from what I got from people that were there, said that, like I said, that she was on the plane and someone took her picture and she told them that she was going to beat her. Well, since it's Patreon, right. She's going to beat her ass, right. Because of the picture. And I'm, like I said, it's because she didn't have her wig on. She had, you know, the shower cap on.
Was
she was
with
in
the red shower cap or whatever.
Yeah.
That was her?
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
She
so she was
presentable.
Exactly.
Which I get. I understand.
Oh, and I understand. And not for nothing. Even though she went extreme,
yeah.
I do understand that. Like, that's why, like, a lot of the famous people, when they come to the airport, if they're not, you know, ready per se, I don't even bother them. Like, I'm just like, all right, cool, you know, like, whatever. Which is
were
like,
you there
I mean,
when that happened? No.
I don't know if I was there because I'm always in the basement, but it did happen Saturday and I do work Saturday. So I just don't know at what time it was. If I could find out the time, I wouldn't know if I was there or not. 1 a.m.?
1 a.m.
Yeah, so then I was totally there.
The guys were started fighting first and then Sexy Red jumped in and started swinging on people.
So then, yes, I was definitely there then. I was definitely there because I worked till 2 a.m. So, yeah, I was definitely there.
Missed all the action.
Oh, yeah. I was in the basement. Like I said, I'm in the basement.
And the little thing I seen on Facebook, it said that the two guys she was with started the fight, or started swinging, and then she came in swinging and then went to get a pole to hit one of them with it.
Yeah, like I said, if you look at the video, I posted it on Ralph's Discord, you could tell like the guys have both started, and then she grabbed the heavy pole to swing, and even one of the guys that's with her kind of like pushed her away to not, you know, because if she would have swung that, she would have killed somebody. I guarantee you, because that thing is super heavy. That's like to kill somebody. But they pushed her, and she was. Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's why she was let go, and she showed up at the pay-per-view on Sunday.
Oh,
probably got a little $100 fine or something. If she even got arrested, they probably just fined her, gave her a little ticket.
Mm-hmm. What's up, Dora Manu Andorfo? What's up?
I was hoping TQ stuck around, man. I want to know.
He's still here.
I'm here.
I don't see him on the panel. That's weird.
I'm here.
So TQ, what's up, man? Let's move on to your story that you were going to say in the beginning. You remember?
Oh, Jerry West died.
What?
Yeah, he died.
Rob's like, what? I don't know who that is. That is a Laker legend. He is actually the NBA logo, Ralph.
Exactly.
Oh, wow. Wait, what? Oh, damn.
The logo for the NBA is actually Jerry West.
What did I think?
No.
Yeah, it might be time to pull them Jerry West jerseys I got out and see what they're going for.
Oh, wow.
Nah, nothing right now.
Damn it, right. He just died a few minutes ago.
No shame.
The man just died a few minutes ago. He's looking to sell his Jerry West jerseys.
You gotta capitalize.
They knew memorabilia. I'm about to sell this shit. Remember that. I'm gonna remember
that.
Not
the first one to do it.
I got two Jerry West jerseys. They're both Mitchell and Ness too. Oh,
fuck.
My little $150 investment might have just brought me back about $500.
The question is, what did he die from?
Old age, I think.
The man had to have been 90 years old.
He was like 87.
Oh, wow.
Still walking, all that.
Somebody should start picking up George Foreman memorabilia.
Oh, fuck.
He's 75.
I got a grill. That helps. And it's got an autograph signature.
Oh, man.
It just says that he died at 86. That's all. What's up, Marley?
What's going on, Marley, from the Underground Shuffle? What's up, bro?
Cool.
What's good, Marley?
What up, Marley?
Stay tuned.
No, just going to speak on that sexy ass stuff.
Yeah, go ahead.
What was she talking about? People got freedom of press. They can take pictures anywhere. Fuck her.
No, but Marley, the point is, and it's like that, like I said, like even for us at the airport, like, you know, like if they're not looking presentable and stuff like that, it's kind of messed up, you know, I get it. You got freedom.
But you're in public, though.
Right.
Like I said, I understand everything. I get it.
I know.
You know, exactly. If you're not presentable, you're not going to want your picture taken. Yeah. They took it to the extreme, which
is
crazy.
This is why celebrities wear hats, shades.
Right. You know?
All that stuff to cover themselves up so they're not known.
Right, to conceal themselves.
It's hard for her.
That's true.
Why?
She's super tatted.
She wears a shirt that covers it.
I mean, she's walking ratchetness.
She is like a walking ratchetness.
On her face, like
yeah, yeah.
Just covered out. Oh damn!
Okay. No, she had tattoos on her face, her chest, her arms, and like she's like super ratchet. That's what I'm saying. She's just like a big troll.
She looked like Young Thug. She's like a female version of Young Thug.
Well, like 100%
female something. Right, well, then that's just comes with the territory. If you want to walk around like a billboard, that's what you can.
Exactly.
Or she knew she was going to be in public. She could have done herself up before she went.
You know, she
it's
is
1 a.m. It's 1 a.m. You're care. Telling me at 1 a.m. you're dressed up into the no
tabloids.
You're on a 1 a.m. flight. You're on a 1 a.m. flight. Trust me, you're not going to be.
Oh, I know,
all...
but no one's out there wanting my picture.
I know you wear your Walmart clothes to the airport.
What?
Sweatpants or your sweat? Or your... baggy t-shirt.
That's what I'm saying. It's
dressed to the nine and high heels.
I didn't say she had to be high heels. I'm not saying she had to be all dolled up. Just be a little bit more presentable because you know that you're a celebrity, so you know someone's going to probably take a picture. So just be half presentable.
No, the point is that you shouldn't be just taking a picture. You should be asking to take a picture at least.
I'm not in public.
Well, yeah, nope. I get it. If you're a a decent human being, but like if you should know.
Oh, so she's not a decent human being because she got tats, Ralph?
No.
Is that what you're saying, Ralph?
No.
People with tattoos are not a decent human being, Ralph?
What are you saying, Ralph?
The people that are taking
so Mike Tyson, because he got his face tatted, is not a decent human being? Go say that to Mike Tyson, Ralph.
I'm talking about the person that's taking the picture. If they're a decent person, they're going to ask. But if you're fucking walking around, you know, people that do tabloids and shit or newspapers, they don't fucking ask. They just paparazzi. They just take pictures.
But the thing is that she was on the plane. So that's what I'm saying. It was on. They were on the plane.
What if the paparazzi was on the plane?
We're all humans at the end of the day. We deserve
it. Still take their picture. What?
Blunt Ninja says, I got a tattoo. Am I not decent?
I'm not talking about them. Decent people that the ones that take the picture. A decent person would ask, "Can I have a picture?"
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. And like I said, she was on the plane. Take a picture. And she was on the plane, so most likely the person probably was sitting across from her and held the phone up really quick on the side, trying to sneak it. You know. Yeah.
You tell me if you saw you work at the airport, you ain't gonna do shit.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying, though.
If you saw J Lo walking down the street, you wouldn't just pop out a phone and just snappy snappy.
But you shouldn't. But that's what I'm saying. Like me at the airport, there's plenty of famous people that I've seen that I don't have pictures with because I'm like, they don't look okay. They look mad. You know, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm not gonna, you know, bother them. It's different. Like I'm telling you, it's different. Being a decent person.
Yeah, but what I'm saying, with that being said.
So just noted, everybody, not only is Ralph racist, he doesn't like tattoos and he thinks you're not decent if you have tattoos, okay?
Yeah. So you're not. So does that warrant her swinging a freaking chair?
No, that's what I said. I said, you know, not to be, you know, that's like they took it to the extreme. That whole thing. That was like she could have literally just said, "Listen, can you just delete the picture? Let me put my stuff on. I'll take a picture with you." You know, she could have done it.
Hell no, man. What? A ratchet? You take a picture of a ratchet who's in her ratchetness? I'm going to sell that shit for $3,000. Hell no. Look at this ratchet bitch.
She really liked that.
I got actual proof that this is not a stunt. She's actually that nasty, you know? Mm-hmm. And I got proof.
See, Molly, but I'm saying is like it, for her to defuse the problem, she could have said that. Even if she would have had her stuff on, you know, whatever. Like she could have just been like, "All right, can you, you know, let's take a real picture together," or just ask. Listen, I'm telling you, what's her name? The chick from Alien.
Fucking Weaver.
I don't know. I haven't watched it.
The girl, Sigourney Weaver. So I saw Sigourney Weaver. This was like 4 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, and she came in, and she had sweats on, a sweatshirt. She had her hoodie up. You know, she just was like, she didn't want to be bothered. And, I saw her and, I was like, "Oh, how you doing? Da, da, da." And, you know, I was like, can I take a picture? And she goes, "No." And I said, "All right." You know, and I just let it be. You know, it's just.
Now, Sexy Red, she put out that aura, you know, that she did it. Oh. Yeah, I want to see her go ahead, be ratchet all day, every day.
But she is ratchet all day, every day. That's the point.
What's wrong with catching her in her ratchetness?
Because obviously, if you catch her in her ratchetness, this is what you're getting now. You going to catch a beatdown. She didn't get locked up. You got locked up. You so because here in Jersey, it's no fault. So guess what? The picture, the person who took the picture, and the person that got in the beatdown all went to jail. And it was a Saturday, so that means they won't be out till Monday.
Well, let's get out sued a bitch.
Jake, they can't. There's no suing. That's the point. This is New Jersey. There's no suing. There's nothing.
Fucking Jersey. It's had to be Jersey. On a Cali on a boat.
Whoa. Sorry.
Are you okay, Ralph?
I was playing Asher's new single.
If you wanted me to shut up, Ralph, I would have just...
No, I'm back.
Marty, you got tattoos, you know? You're not
right, I got tattoos, man. I'm not a decent
whammy, too, and he's racist. Oh, that's a double whammy. Oh,
I know, man. Racist and doesn't like tattoos. He's, Ralph got that. Ralph got that double.
In the words of Ralph, you want to go around looking like a billboard,
that's
all. Oh, man. Yeah, Blunt. You hear that, Blunt? We're billboards now. We're fucking billboards.
100%.
I got a color tattoo. So did that make me a coloring book, Ralph?
Tattoo WSN.
I know, man. My tattoos are colored too. Damn, I'm a coloring book too.
Tattoo steals.
What?
Same here, guys.
Tattoo.
Ralph, you have a whole panel of indecent people on here. Yeah.
I didn't know you had a tattoo.
Coloring books, bro. Of coloring.
Bunch of pieces of shit.
We're fucking beautiful.
Bunch of indecent people with tattoos.
Bunch of
really billboards.
I'm
sleeved
up, backed up.
You bunch of billboards.
Fucking billboards.
You might as well have vote for Trump on you, damn it.
What did I miss?
You missed everything, Mama Bear. Go back to Canada.
I am in Canada.
Okay, then stay your butt in. So stay in the kitchen. Let me stop.
I am in the kitchen. I am in the kitchen.
I know. That's the best part of it.
You making popcorn? You washing dishes? What's going on?
She's washing dishes. What is it called? Barefoot.
Barefoot
in the kitchen.
She's barefoot in the kitchen.
Barefoot in the kitchen?
I am barefoot in the kitchen, to tell you the truth. I got bare feet on. Bare feet on. Yeah, I got bare feet on.
You got bare feet on?
You're Mama Bear with bare
feet. You're a bear. I would have.
Cannibal, too?
She's a cannibal, yes. She's definitely a cannibal. You found it. Did you find all your clips?
No, just.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
So, are you going to tell me what you guys
are Ralph is saying that people with tattoos are not decent.
He called them billboards.
What?
He said they're billboards.
Oh, my God. I wasn't talking about that.
Ralph, he said they're a bunch of billboards.
I feel so bad for you, bro.
He called them a fucking billboard.
What does that mean, though?
He's trying to get a word in. It's just like, he just calls bums. Called us billboards.
I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to do it, Ralph. You're trying to frick her.
Fucking billboards.
Well, guess what? So everybody up here has a tattoo?
You don't have a tattoo?
Does everybody up here on this panel have a tattoo?
Do you have a tattoo? Do you have a tattoo, Mama Bear?
Do you have a tattoo?
I asked you first.
Okay, that I answered your question if you answer ours. Do you have a tattoo?
No, I don't.
So exactly.
Everybody on the panel.
So you guys all have tattoos.
Everybody on the panel. Yeah, every guy on the panel except for Ralph has a tattoo.
Oh, fuck
I know Ralph don't.
The Buddha.
Stills, for real though, I didn't know you had a tattoo.
What do you got?
I got three tattoos, but it's all right.
What are they?
Damn. Shit, damn, that's your friend? Oh, fuck exactly. No.
I know, TQ. This is the stuff I go through. This is the stuff I go through.
I don't even know this man got a tattoo.
You got that shamrock on your left cheek. I do.
I got a tattoo that says Epic Strategies Network.
That's a lot.
Fuck yeah. It's not April Fool's Day today.
No.
I technically got I got three tattoos. I got I got this on my left hand. I'm trying to think. Left hand, I have the Stairways to Heaven, and there's like the Gates of Heaven. There's two little angels in there. On my back shoulder blade, I have a little devil. And then on my right side, I have Marvin the Martian. Holding a mic with a big number one on his chest.
What?
Why?
Oh, I forgot about that. I think.
Okay, so
I got a little devil on my shirt.
Stop, fair use. Yeah, man.
I didn't even know you had it. I forgot you had a tattoo. Jesus, that's crazy. Yep,
I got three tattoos. So long. Fair use. Do you have tattoos?
No tattoos.
So you're a decent person. To keep you updated.
Oh, Ralph, right there. High five.
Exactly.
Oh, fair use left. Fair use left. Oh no, he's there.
No.
Fair use. Just to keep you updated. Ralph said anybody with tattoos is not a decent person.
There you go.
Everybody on the panel?
Degenerate.
I wasn't
bunch of degenerates.
He said you're a walking billboard. He said you're not a decent person if you have tattoos.
I might have said that, but I didn't say you guys were picking decent. I wasn't talking about you guys.
God will judge you.
Okay, oh so why God. Are you saying why did you say you people with tattoos?
Are you a walking billboard too?
Huh? Why did Hold you on. Say that?
Too many people talking. Too many people. What'd you say, TQ?
Asking Fair, is he a billboard like us too?
No, Fair said he doesn't have.
No, he said no. And Mama Bear, what did you say?
No.
Why did you say that?
Nah, not for free, bro. Pay me. You want some of this real estate? You gotta pay.
There he goes. He's a walking billboard. So, Mama Bear, what happened was we were talking about Sexy Red. And how she has tattoos on her face, on her chest, on everything. And and he goes, well, if you want to be a walking billboard, you know, type thing. And then we all started. And then he goes, well, you know, if you're not a decent human being. And he honestly didn't finish before we were all like, oh, you're calling us the undecent because of tattoos. And blah, blah, blah. But hey, then man, he said,
you know,
but then he corrected himself, you know.
You know, I was going to tell you that I received a call from someone that I needed to patch through to customer service last night. I'm not sure. I don't think they're on hold anymore, but I was going to try to patch them through to you. Maybe we can get a call back. But apparently we had a situation in the airport lobby with a Sexy Red individual.
So and, it wasn't in the lobby.
It was at the gate, right?
It was at the gate. Yeah, this was Saturday.
Yeah, right in front of the doors.
It was Saturday at 1 a.m. And I was actually there. I didn't know what time it was because I just found out about it yesterday. But it was Saturday and I was there. And it was 1 a.m. in the morning. Supposedly what happened was somebody on the plane took her picture. And she said, when we get off the plane, I'm gonna beat your ass. And her bodyguards and everything like that actually did all the fighting and everything. That's why she was let go or just a fine or whatever. And because on Sunday, she actually was the host of WWE's NXT pay-per-view.
Mm. Wow, what a world we live in, man. You can't take a picture of celebrity.
This is what I was saying, Fair. I said the problem was, okay, in which, I mean, like I said, I know both, I see both sides. But the problem was, is 1 a.m. in the morning, the person didn't ask for the picture, probably took the picture. She wasn't in her, you know, in her form. She didn't have her wig on. She didn't have, you know, whatever. Well, no. Like I said, this is, you know, it's, I see both sides of the story, but like I said, she could have just, Sexy Red literally could have just been like, listen, let me put my wig on, let me, you know, do it, and we can take a picture together instead of going the ratchet way, which she is,
and go to jump her and do everything else. But
yeah, nah, I don't
the
think
opposite side, the opposite side is the person was trying to sneak the picture. So obviously the person was trying to, you know, kind of like catch her out there and probably try to sell the picture.
It don't matter. It don't matter because none of it warrants physical assault.
Oh no,
it warrants physical assault at all.
I agree on that part.
By her bodyguards, especially for filming in a public place. I mean, number one, you're a celebrity or you're a person of known interest. You put yourself out there, then this is what comes with putting yourself out there.
Facts.
So if you're not ready because if you're wearing whatever because you just woke up, that's on you. You should be presentable knowing that you're a quote celebrity and you're gonna be out there and people are gonna snatch your picture.
Fuck yeah,
did the girl get to keep
but it's 1 a.m. man, it's 1 a.m.
it don't matter.
What's 1 a.m.
what's the difference between 1 a.m. and
I'm saying it's 1 a.m. in the morning, you're on a flight. It's 1 a.m. in the morning. You're on a flight. You're not thinking that someone's going to take your picture on the flight. You know, like I said, like I was telling these guys. So I saw Sigourney Weaver, right? And she was in a, you know, sweatsuit, hoodie, you know, shade. She didn't want to, you know, and I asked her, I said, hey, do you mind taking a picture? And she said, no. And I was like, all right. Like, you know, and I let it be. It's just... it's just decency to ask, you know. Like I said, if you're just snapping pictures, it's more like you're trying to sell the picture. You're trying to, you know, be like, hey, look who I caught out there, da 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 da. Which, you know, like I said, it's they're public. I get it. They're public. They're famous. They should be, you know, like that. But it's as a decent human being, you could have just asked too.
Did the girl?
How many times have we?
What were you saying, Fair? Huh?
I think Tracy was asking about if she got to keep the picture.
Yeah.
Who knows? She probably did. I mean,
I was just going to ask about, like, well, what happens with all these people that are on a plane and somebody decides to start filming or take pictures because something's going on in the plane? None of the people on the plane have signed up or given their consent to be going viral.
Because it's public, and I get it.
Okay, well then it don't matter then. Like, but then my point is like it shouldn't warrant physical assault.
I agree on that. Yeah, and I agree on that. And I agree 100% that like I said, Sexy Red, she's so ratchet that she decided she wanted to do it that way. Like she literally could have said, mm-hmm. All right, listen, you want my picture? Okay, let me just put my wig on. Or even if she was keeping her stuff on, like if she didn't feel like changing, be like, all right, let's just take a real picture. Like, you know, like, and you can delete that picture type thing.
Right.
I don't know, because I've seen pictures of her being ratchet in her bonnet, looking, whatever. Yeah.
But I know that's
I'm guessing it's okay if she take the picture of herself in that ratchetness.
But that's what I'm saying. I don't know. But Marley, that's my point though, is that she's so used to being ratchet and having her picture. If the person would have said, hey, do you mind taking a picture? She probably would have just taken the picture even in her ratchetness with the fucking thing on. The fact that the person just took the picture is probably what caused everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I'm saying. It's just
the law. It was probably because she just didn't know the law of public photography.
I don't think it had to do with her being ratchet. It's just fucking... she just fucking, that's just the way she is. It's not even.
She is ratchet. That's exactly why it is.
That's not true because that's just the way she is. We got to accept her for how she is because I'm pretty sure a lot of people from her area are not ratchet. But that's just the way some people is. But
she's ratchet. She's ratchet.
Oh, yeah. That's the way she is. But that don't give her no fucking right.
Oh no! Like I said, and I agree that she has no right to be beating people up and whatever. And like I said, she technically didn't beat nobody up because she got off with a fine. So you know, if you see the video, her bodyguard pushed her and everything like that, so that she wouldn't get it. You know,
She was picking up a freaking stand, bro. She picked up a freaking pole stand to throw.
I know. Like, and that's what I
not
said.
Attempted it, anything. Like, I don't know. I mean, I don't know. For me personally, I don't think any kind of weave. I don't think any kind of makeup. I don't think any kind of anything. I don't care if it's tattoo removal. Ain't nothing gonna help that shorty, yo. Like, for real, she like that that's attitude fun. Only makes it worse. Like, there's nothing photogenic there to start with. I'm just saying.
Huh?
Yeah. I just feel like it really did just fall on. She didn't know. Like, she didn't know the law of public photography because.
But you know to just get. But you know to just beat somebody's ass like on the airport.
I was about to say that. In other words, I mean, it's common sense at the end of the day. Like, fuck. No, you're in the public. You're a public figure. Like Fair said, you're a celebrity status. Of course, somebody's gonna take out a fucking.
But TQ, just remember, public. Public, what did you say?
Public photography.
Public photography. A lot of people don't understand what that is.
Yeah, it's the rule. I think she didn't understand the rule. Like, far as her putting her hands on somebody, like, I'm with y'all 100%.
Yeah, 100%
on that too. But no, it doesn't give her the right to just, you know, throw hands. But she just didn't know that. It was okay for them to do it, so she thought.
You know, okay, like I said, it was on the plane. It was on the plane, so in her head, you know, even if she knows whatever public, whatever, da 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 da, she figures she's on a plane that, you know, it's not that it's public. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people don't see that a plane is a public place. You know, they see it. It's you're on a plane. You're I don't know how to put it. It's that it's private for you. You know, like that's what I said. Like the fact that the person took the picture on the plane, most likely it was like trying to sneak the picture. You know,
I used to go out with a photographer, and you don't want your picture taken all the time unless you look presentable.
Oh fuck yeah! Oh, fuck yeah.
Incoming clip from Mr.
Incoming clip, Ralph. Go.
It could be, it could have been worse. Well, I don't know worse, but this gets me cringy sometimes where these people go into federal buildings and start filming.
That's a public place. Federal, it means it belongs to the people.
Okay.
That's my point that we
all be in court right now, right? Okay, your body cam is on?
I'm sorry?
Your body cam is on?
It is.
Okay, great.
Gentlemen, here at the Employee
Post Officer's
Office, this is a federal building.
You cannot
report.
Bro, that's
the
shit out of me.
Officer McQueen, yeah. I want to show you something, and maybe you too, supervisors. What was your name again?
Justin.
So I'm going to bring you over here, okay. And I'm going to show you these. This is the rules and regulations governing the conduct on postal property.
Okay.
If you read right here, photographs. For news purposes, may be taken, and commercial purposes, may be taken in entries, lobbies, foyers. So
you,
I have.
You just said photographs.
Photographs, video.
So did I say photographs and video, or just photographs?
Photographs and video are the same thing, officer.
Photographs and video are two different things.
Same thing.
Not 101 video.
I'm telling you, I am a journalist.
Okay.
I'm working on a story on this post office.
Okay.
So not only does the rules and regulations allow me to be here.
Okay.
But the First Amendment of the Constitution, freedom of press, allows me to be here and record. This is a public building. Unfortunately, Justin, that's not true. I'm sorry to tell you, it's not true. I'm independent.
Right, so you got any type of identification on you?
No, I don't need any identification.
I know you work for the press.
No, well, everybody has the freedom of press, sir.
Oh, but you said you work for the press. You are the press.
I am the press.
Okay.
Yes, I am the press.
So I'm a journalist.
I'm a journalist working on a story on the post office.
Okay.
If you prevent that in any way, you will be violating my civil rights. You'll be violating my rights to film.
Okay.
I can film in a public lobby.
So does that say photographs or video?
This grants me the permission to take videos in the lobby. So
does that say photographs or video?
Maybe you should talk to the postmaster. Maybe he's a supervisor, and I get that, but maybe you should talk to the postmaster because the postmaster will be more knowledgeable on the subject.
Okay.
Before you
just wanted to read something to me, but you said it was just photographs.
Yeah, this is photographing.
That's not photographs.
Yes, it's the same. It's the same thing,
so
officer.
So photographing video is the same exact thing.
It's the same thing. I have freedom of the press. I'm allowed to be here and record in the lobbies. The rules say it, and much more than the rules. And by the way, this is federal law. It's just not some poster. This is federal law.
Okay.
He informed me that I'm breaking federal law filming, which I know not to be the case. And on top of that, I have freedom of press. I can record in public buildings. This is a public building. Yeah. I know you said it's a federal building, okay. But federal means public. It's right. The same thing.
Okay. Would you be able to carry firearms in this building too?
I don't know. So I don't have a firearm, so I don't know.
Okay. Do you have any ID on you?
I'm not going to give you any ID.
Whew. I'm not going to give you any ID.
Wow.
Yeah, fuck.
Wow.
Yeah.
Freedom of press.
Exactly.
Police need to know their laws, man.
Exactly. Now, yeah.
Police and laws.
Who's the police? Doing, man?
Chapter 7.
Who's policing the police?
It's just... I'm not giving my opinion, just saying anybody can be pretty much press, right? Like anybody can just walk in like, hey, I'm an independent journalist.
Come along with your freedom of speech, man. It's the same amendment.
Freedom of speech, freedom of press, freedom of expression. It's not like they're asking for like proof, like I want to see your press card or whatever. Like you can just say I'm an independent journalist. I do a blog on my website, epicstrategiesnetwork.com. And yeah. You know,
so
I'm allowed to.
I mean, are you surprised? Don't we see this all the time? We play clips of these kind of people.
Yeah. So you know what's crazy, Ralph? So at the airport, when people come with all their, you know, camera equipment, mm-hmm. all that stuff, we literally have to ask them every time. We need to see your press pass and press this mm-hmm. and press that. Oh, wow. And a bunch of them will be like, no, well, you don't have to. And we're like, yes, we do. If you want to get the discount, you have to show it. No. And it's a big fight. Right. And it's like, and we, you know, we tell the supervisors and stuff, and like, listen, like this is a fight constantly, and you know, and they're like, well, does it matter if they want to get the discount? They have to show it. They have to show their press pass. They have
so
to show their.
So you can get a discount if you're press. If you say you're press.
Oh yeah, you get a big discount.
Oh, yeah. Man, we can make our own press passes.
Yeah, but you have to
Ralph.
Be. But you have to like have like camera equipment and stuff like that too. Like you can't just it's not just your luggage, it's all the press stuff that gets the discount.
You better get on that, Ralph. You better get on that.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, you're the one who got the air miles, Ralph. Go ahead.
I mean we don't tell me.
Yeah, bro.
But nowadays you don't really need a lot of heavy equipment. Like all you,
not like
you, bro. You can just get
homie
TikTok shop. Those,
let me
those
tell you,
cams, bro.
Let me tell you, like when it's press. Let me tell you, when it's press, we know.
No, I believe it
because yeah, these they come with carts,
they come deep
with cameras and stuff like
they
that.
They go
oh,
deep.
Yeah.
That's when you know it's legit and stuff like that.
It's usually like we'll get like one or two people that come with like four cameras and they're like, oh, we're press. It's like, dude, you have four cameras. You can take that on the plane with you. Right. Like you don't need to check it. You don't need to get a discount.
All right.
You know.
Yeah. Here's an extreme example. Just so that nobody gets like too sensitive over it. Just an extreme example.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Hard on moment.
Well, no. Maybe. It could go that way. The problem with not being able to take pictures and filming on the plane. Like, what? How did that work for, like, hijacks and shit like that? And people that were taking pictures when that happened or recordings of that moment? Like, are they going to give them a problem? If something happens and they try to release it, or they put it out on their social media or something like that, or is that like an isolated case?
Well,
you know what I'm saying? Like, how can they say like you can't do that when there could be an opportunity where it could be needed?
Yeah, no. Like I'm telling you right now that motherfucker is not real. If it was for me.
I wish I had that clip.
If it wasn't for a camera, we would have never had that. So
yeah,
you know,
right here, tomato. She would never be famous without that. See,
pros and cons again. Pros and cons.
No, but I'm saying it's not that you can't. It's not that you can't take pictures on a plane or video on a plane.
Because
it's
done that.
Every day.
Well,
I was looking out
the window. I wasn't taking pictures of nobody.
No, but it's done. It's, you know, and like I said, that's what I was agreeing with Fair Use that it can be done. It's not a
It's not a thing. It's just a fact. Like I said, it's
yeah.
She was probably
a ratchet person. You're gonna get ratchet responses. That's pretty much what.
Yeah, there you go.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Pretty much. Got to accept them for who they are. I told you.
Yeah. Fuck. Whereas if you were taking a picture of J-Lo, you'll probably just get a dirty look.
J-Lo might whistle a pistol whip somebody, you know?
Really? Oh.
She was just mad.
Yeah, with Diddy's gun.
On her knees when she got her picture taken.
You know, J-Lo's going down with Diddy, guys. I don't know.
Y'all noticed she was
J-Lo went down.
She was J-Lo on a block when she was with Diddy, right?
Yeah, that's what I said. Yeah. She always had the headband on, you know.
I thought it was gonna be hard. It's soft.
The headband and the hammer, yo, for real.
She banging in Spanish.
Oh yeah.
Hey. I don't remember that J-Lo. I remember the Olympic J-Lo.
She was chilling with D-Block a lot.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Oh, D-Block! Shit. I see what you did there, Steve.
Amatola is Mariah Carey's former husband. He was like a warden. Doesn't she look so happy to be with him? From what I understand, this man was incredibly abusive and controlling with her. And when she tried to leave him, he said, bet. Classic narcissist style. I will find someone to replace you who vaguely looks like you, who can do almost the same things you can do. Think Kanye and his new wife. Similar themes. Jennifer Lopez was a dancer on In Living Color, if I'm correct, in the 90s. Didn't really have a singing career. I imagine they just met, or he said, get her, bring her to me. And he gave her a singing career from what we all understand. We can ask Ashanti if you want to. I don't have anything to prove. I can't prove any of this. Entertainment purposes only. Anyways, he goes, he finds her. He installs her with a singing career that she knows that she doesn't deserve because she's not a singer. At some point, I am sure that he told her what he wanted her to do, which was to take out Mariah Carey, something she was never capable of doing. Because Mariah Carey is actually very talented, right? What Hollywood does, I find, is find people who don't have too much talent. They create a talent out of them by a lot of smoke and mirrors, and then probably tell the person, don't even try to step out of line because you don't really have any talent. You're just here because I let you be. I was around when Jennifer Lopez was coming up and becoming famous, and I think the biggest reason that she became famous is because of her makeup artist. Does everyone remember this video, Waiting for Tonight? Ooh, the glow. Something we are all still striving to achieve this day and age in 2024. Also because there wasn't a lot of Latina representation. She had a realistic body type. Remember everyone always talked about her booty cheeks? I feel like she and Beyonce ushered in a new portion of body acceptance. I was there for it. I don't want to compare them at all. They're not in the same league, but you get it. Oh, also this dress and her dating Sean Combs, which let's get into it. At this point, knowing what we know about him, we can assume that she was being used by him in many different ways. She was fine with that. She was more than happy to become even more famous than she was. In fact, I don't think she would even become as famous as she was without that relationship with him. And this video is tricky because I never want to say like, oh, this woman owes her career to these men. In fact, they used her. And clearly this is like something is coming around. Diddy's in court. And
now, do you think this lady here is just trying to
she's white, right? She's white, right? Yeah, she's white. Yeah, she's white.
Kind of like Michael Jackson white.
Yeah, she's white. She's white. She's white. She's white. She's jealous. She's white. She's jealous. She's white. She's jealous of the Spanish chick.
What are you saying, Ralph?
R&R moment.
I sent it to Steele so he can see. But I don't know what that makes a difference. But yeah,
I feel like she's trying to get on a level with that other chick.
Jaguar Wright. So,
yeah, I think she's just trying to get on another level with her because
Jaguar Wright.
She's saying when you were talking about people who are famous for saying dumb stuff or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Is Jaguar Wright and the stuff that she says, or she's just spewing out stuff?
I'm going to tell you one thing, Ralph. I'm going to tell you one thing, okay? I'm going to tell you one thing right now. If a person is speaking about somebody and there's lies, that is defamation. And you can sue someone for defamation, and you go to court, similar to how Rudy Giuliani went to court and Trump went to court for defamation, and they lost. Yeah. Well, she can get sued. Jaguar Wright can get sued for defamation, yet no one has brought charges on her. Right. No one has sued her yet. So, is she really telling the lie?
She's gone far too late.
Did you know what I found out about her suit fair use?
What's up? I found she just got Erica, locked up.
Her cousin, Erica Badu, is her cousin. Word? Yeah,
oh, wow. I didn't know that.
Somebody else is her cousin. I got to read up about Erica Badu is her cousin. So she's been around the music industry for a minute to know.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. I remember her from when she came out, with her like neo soul kind of sound, you know, back in like the late 90s, I think.
Yeah.
She was running with the Roots for a little bit, I think.
Yeah, that's where I know him from. Yeah, because Questlove and they. Yeah, yeah. But like you said, people get sued for defamation. Nobody has attempted to sue her yet.
Wasn't she part of like the OK Player and you know all that stuff? Like,
yeah,
I think she was even on the album.
Yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah, when that first came out, when that first dropped. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just wait. She's gonna be the first person key of interest that we look to get our info from. Because what made me put my antennas up is when she was talking about Kim Porter and Heavy D and I'll Be Sure. Wow. And everybody that was about to write a tell-all book ended up passing away or getting ill. And the only person that in that circle that hasn't been touched is who? Diddy. So I was like, oh, yeah. She's kind of right, and they was coming out, and and it's in black and white. This guy's an informant. It's in black and white. So if you want to be naive, that's for on real. You. But Diddy's an informant, and with that being said, he has people in high places. Like you know, they can make you, they can make you have a heart attack. You know, by doing whatever they do, food, shooting you, whatever type of laser, whatever the fuck. And I know it sounds far fetched, but don't be naive to it. And then it'll
already have an example of Kim Porter. That's fairly mysterious. Also, I'll Be Sure, right? It was a little mysterious. I mean, he hasn't come out and said anything, but people around the community die.
Yeah, die. Like what they said about Kim Porter.
Fuck you for that. Fuck you for letting that out of control whack ass fucking whoremonger and sodomite just run rampant all over this goddamn fucking business. Fuck you for that. Like Andre was different. Andre had class. Andre had some integrity. But no, you go to get the little Chucky doll.
Andre is Dr.
That
Dre.
Fucker. I'm sorry, I'm a little upset about it. Because Al B. Sure just came out of his coma, and I've been talking to Al, and we've been texting back and forth, and I'm just glad that he's alive to text.
Oh, definitely.
But when you think about Kim, I was thinking to myself the other day, Uptown Records started with five people. Andre Harrell, I'll Be Sure.
Heavy D.
And Puffy. And Kim was the longest working employee because she was there from the very beginning. She was Andre's.
And Epic Strategies Network was started by three. Sorry, I just wanted to throw that in there.
Kim is dead.
Yeah, why are there death angels behind that?
Andre Harrell is dead. The only two left more dramatic are Puffy and Al, and Al almost died.
Like, I hate when they add that
the music.
Heavy D was found dead, face down, and
that's about
Andre Harrell, heart attack. Kim died from pneumonia, but there's the first coroner's report that said that she died. It was ruled a homicide, and they found toxins in her body to prove that she had been poisoned. You know, they have poisons that create heart attack and pneumonia-like symptoms. And then right after that, Al had a meeting, and I was going to meet up with him because we were in Vegas. And then the next thing you know, you want to know what they all had in common, though?
Tell our book.
The survivors and the late of Uptown Records, they were all writing tell-all books. Mm-hmm. Andre was writing a book right before he died. Heavy D was working on a book before he died. Kim Porter was working on a book before she died, and Al B. Shore was working on the documentary of his life, and then he goes into a coma. Has Puffy ever been in a coma? Has anything happened to him? He must be the luckiest motherfucker, because it seems like everybody that worked at Uptown Records from the very beginning is gone. Just him. I guess Al disappointed you. You know, it's fuck you royally and fuck you.
Yeah.
It's crazy, right?
Yeah, I heard when I first
heard that's what her. Yeah, me too. That's why I was like, nah, she knows something.
For not too much.
That's the thing. And they keep out, they watching her too. Cause they were like, yeah, she whistleblowing. They on her head, especially Diddy.
She just got locked up. She just got locked up two days ago, and she got
petty for some petty shit.
For not returning a U-Haul truck, man. They got her for grand larceny and shit.
Wow.
But she's out. She's out now.
So small.
Oh, damn, that's crazy. I didn't know that.
They'll find anything to put on somebody, man.
That's
she's out. She's out, and there was an interview that she did yesterday after she came out. She dropped another interview. But yeah, she's good. She explained why they got her, how they got her with the whole U-Haul truck shit situation.
I need to find that.
Yeah, but just get ready, because they're not no like TikTok length videos, man. Her videos are long, bro.
Yeah,
you got to go to YouTube for her shit.
So why did, if he was smart, he would have gotten somebody to do something to him to cover it up.
What do you mean?
So that he would end up in the hospital or something, like just do something.
Like fake some retaliation. I mean, that would have straight up movie, man. Movie stuff.
Ralph, that cup keeps my stuff hot in it.
Oh, good. I like it.
I don't. It's burning my tongue.
Oh.
Burning my tongue.
I ain't no punk bitch.
It's okay. Ralph's not there. You don't need to use your tongue.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for Puffy to steal my bodyguard to off himself, because he's telling a whole lot too.
Oh man.
Yeah, geez, you.
Yeah, because
he's saying some wild stuff too.
Say who bodyguard?
Puffy's bodyguard.
Oh, Glenn.
Gene Deal.
Yeah, Gene, that motherfucker. He knows some shit too. He knows about the party shit, so they gonna silence him pretty soon too.
he's been talking a lot about the time when Biggie got shot too. He had a lot to say.
Don't
about
forget
that.
You spent time in Philly. Lots of time in Philly. That's my
He was talking about the one the winner that I'll bring you to my page and I'll go live with him on Instagram about your misdealings and your misdeeds in Philadelphia. Cause you thought you was the queen of everything. You came to Philly, yo. And right now you sniffing idiot, I ain't the one, and you don't want the work I got for you.
So it looks like Jaguar Wright is not done speaking on Nicki Minaj just yet, because she just went off on her and exposed her for being a raging freak-off addict. Jaguar claims that Nicki and her SA offender husband, Kenneth Petty, have a house that she bought specifically to indulge in freak-offs with underage boys and girls, and that she even saw a disturbing video footage of Megan having a freak-off with Nicki. A lot of people were shocked to hear about Megan and Nicki freaking off, because not too long ago, they were at each other's necks, and Nicki even brought up Megan's dead mom.
Wow.
I heard about that, and Jaguar Wright said he's seen the fucking video. So there's a video. I need to see it for research purposes, too.
Yeah, this is for educational purposes.
Educational purposes.
It's for podcasts.
I don't know. I just want to learn. I'm a learner.
Yeah, I need to learn.
What happens when
investigative reporting?
All right, what happened when two women have a freak off? What is that?
Why are they using freak off? Like,
I'm really going to exercise my right.
Why are they using the phrase freak off? I don't know what that means. Do they sit there and do their taxes together? I don't know what that means.
This is a term that's been brought up in the Diddy lawsuit.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So, because in the lawsuit that was brought up against Diddy by Lil Rob or whatever his name is, there he mentioned that these freak offs. I think also Cassie mentioned in her lawsuit about these freak offs and what would go down, and all the details around that. Yeah, but Diddy basically likes to you know, have these quote unquote sex workers, these women, and have them pleasuring male prostitutes while he watches and pleasures himself, videotapes everything, has these parties. Yeah, where you been? Where you guys been?
In Canada.
Off of Patreon.
Canada, right?
Fucking freak nasty motherfucker.
Oh, I didn't hear about but I didn't hear about the pleasuring himself part.
Yeah,
take that.
There's a whole thing where there's a whole thing where they mentioned that he likes to see the hand wrapped around the best burrito club while the nails are.
Good segue into the commercial.
Anyway, I wish I had it queued up. Man, put his hand around the best burrito club.
Best burrito club.
That's when Ariane walks in.
That would be funny if Ariane just popped in, like, whoa. Yeah.
What? What I mean?
Funny if he popped in, yeah.
It would be funny.
It just sounds like Diddy trying to become, I guess, Hugh Hefner, but in a bad way. like, man, what is happening?
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy because there's no, I mean, Playboy is pretty much done with, right? So, like, there needs to be a new medium. Maybe these,
but
selling this, it off,
he
right?
has, it's like,
yeah, bro. But this is like without telling people. This is without their consent. This is like totally illegal, bro. Like,
yeah, well, that's, you know, that's what happens when you have power. These things don't matter to you.
Nah, that shit don't matter.
To the Playboy mansion.
While we were at the front desk showing the attendant that he was stalking us and the hotel live online. Real life.
It ain't real life, just a real thing. Real life street stars, know what time it is.
Free at last, God Almighty,
So I'm assuming this is the one where she gets out of the jail. This is the most recent video.
Because normally...
But...
I thought you was watching Martin Luther King.
Yo, Mike drops it.
Yeah.
But it's
Neo Drill.
We're doing a first day out interview style. First hour out.
Oh my God. And,
man, let's just do it like this, because what people don't know is that and now the cat's out the bag. We had a moment, Jag, with Gene Deal where you came in. We haven't put it out yet, but you and Gene Deal had a moment right there, person.
Like, I don't know how to do this. Like, should I just stop and go, just keep it going? Like, I don't know.
Get your hand around your mouth and go up and down.
I just replay the whole thing. We'll go little by little.
Can be together soon. I hope that we can be together soon. Can you make it real soon? Can you make it real? Wait a minute, when he bucked there with the
I didn't know that was coming. So hopefully by the time this is out, people will know what that is, but man.
My God.
That was a moment in
me and Big Bro.
Man, we had a great time. It was a great night. We had some drinks, we had some laughs. You went on your way. About to head back to where you're about to head to the next day.
Yeah.
Your job in D-Town was done.
Yeah.
You were done. You were good.
I was Gucci.
You were good to go.
Wait, what's D-Town? Is that supposed to mean something else?
Dallas, maybe?
Detroit? I don't
know. Is that Dallas?
Walk us through that morning, because
she's in Dallas.
Oh, okay.
I can't walk you through it because the morning started before I woke up.
Oh.
And I thought it was going to be hard. It sucked.
So, right, we left here on a high. It was a beautiful night. We got Ange at home in time for bedtime where he can get his TV and have his smoke and chill. Like, everything was perfect. And I said I want to take a walk, and I walk my baby downtown, and he's never been to Dallas.
There you go.
I'm Dallas.
Chauffeur.
Now. Yeah, right. Chauffeur on the feet. We took a walk.
Beautiful.
That's great. Talked to the mod squad, tapped in with them, let them know they were going to get their autographed real life street stars t-shirt.
Yes, boy, yes, yes.
Gotta say that on camera. Now y'all know I had.
We got it warmed up. All right, there you go.
And that's becoming a thing, ain't it?
It's becoming
the real life street star t-shirt.
It's becoming a
whole fucking thing. Like, young man showed up here without it, pressed it, and said, "I gotta represent."
Got to, without question.
Respect.
I am.
Wait. Is this still nighttime that you're doing this walk? Is it still?
Yeah.
Oh, it's the wee hours of the morning now.
It was like.
Oh.
It was about 2:30 a.m. Nice twilight. I wanted him to see what downtown looked like.
Tonight's not just.
So she's talking about going out with her boo thing. On the stroll when she got out of jail.
No, before. She's setting up the scene as to how the events occurred.
Okay.
$50 burger.
The best burgers, I hope. The
best burger. I don't know. I didn't eat it. How was it, Ange?
Too big.
It was too big.
$50 is better.
That's what she said.
Hey. That part. Yeah, because I went to jail. Got to eat my $50 burger.
Damn it. So, all right. So,
that was the plan. The $50 burger. The Ruby Redbird China box that only comes out this time of year. And I got to share it with my beloved because he loves IPAs like I love IPAs. And now that I've been, you know, Texas almost a decade, I love China. You know? So it was like a real whole moment. Like, my big bro is here. You know, y'all found out he could sing.
Just like
and
that.
It was just a great night. And we went to sleep and everything was beautiful. And when I woke up alone.
Okay.
With coffee on the ledge.
Okay.
Oh, that's what Fair Use does with blunt.
My man was gone.
Okay.
And I'm like, hold up. So I look and he's in the chat.
Oh.
And we're being stalked by Squidward, aka Queen Twirl, aka King World 2020.
Can I say this? King World is where I saw, after the fact, I had to go back and watch his live to see you were going live. Did you go live that morning?
Mm-hmm.
So I saw that on his page. So
ain't nobody afraid of nothing.
He was watching.
He was stalking.
Okay.
Like he did last year at Southside on Lamar.
All right. So for those who don't, like me, I don't know who none of these people are, who they're talking about. Does anybody want to paraphrase or summarize?
No idea. I guess some kind of live streamer, influencer kind of thing.
Okay.
This story got me all confused. I know.
I'm trying to get to like the nooks and crannies of it, but there's a lot of fluff here.
Yeah, it's Jaguar Wright. It's her man's that she's going out on a date with in Dallas. She's showing him around the town. They went to go have dinner. There's a place out there where you can get. Yeah, there's a place out there where you can get these $50 burgers. And it sounds like it only comes out in a specific time of year, like now. I'm not sure. She drops the name of the place, but I'm not sure what that $50 burger is about. I will do some research and let you know on that. But there was some other person, a live streamer, who I guess was mentioning something on the live stream, and that's what they were referring to.
Okay. I think TQ should, if he's out there in that area, should go get that burger.
But isn't he in Cali? Or is he in Texas?
Oh, wait. Where was she? Oh, I thought she was
in Dallas.
Oh, Dallas. Oh, Texas.
Well, he can go there, too.
Never mind. Somebody in Texas should go there.
At least somebody's paying.
Are you not somebody. Like right down there.
Say what?
Are you not listening to the same shit we are?
No, I'm listening. Listen. When I'm asking for a summary, I'm not saying like repeat like
17 times, bro.
What I'm hearing. I'm just, oh, yeah, I didn't hear that part. I didn't hear that. Anyway, let's continue on. Let's see what that is. Shit is all about.
Which morning?
The morning of.
No.
And that's the question. Because people want to say,
the day before.
People say, she's back at
the pool.
We were live the day before.
The day before.
Right. So I don't want people to think that she was at the pool again.
No.
Yes. Okay.
They tried to get me arrested in the pool, not this time. Right. Front desk.
Front desk this time. So did you know what was coming down? Did you see anything that looked weird or out of place as it was happening? Or you just.
I know the analytics. I know how they work. I know they're not intelligent. I know they're not creative. I know they're looking to recreate a moment that they incepted onto YouTube for their negative campaign against me. What a difference a year makes. This time last year, I was an unverified, unreputable, never been liar. And this year, I'm an oracle of hip hop. What a difference a year makes.
I thought it was going to be hard. It sucked. Yeah. I thought it was going to be hard.
I'm
it
on
sucked.
Social media and I'm looking and I just see, I run across an interview and Tasha Kay's talking.
Oh.
And she says, I got what I prayed for.
And guess what my answer is?
What's that?
Can I play it for you? You don't have to worry about blocking it out. It belongs to me. It's my original music. This is my answer to you, Transrena. Even your mama knew you was a piece of shit when you was born.
Oh.
Who would name their daughter, their cisgender daughter, a tranny?
Oh.
I don't know. Maybe a woman who would allow her boyfriend to violate her daughter so he could keep paying her rent. I interviewed him. Just like I interviewed Chek's mistress, other than Chelsea, your assistant, your little minion, who you hooked up with a deadbeat that you told her was a millionaire, and now she's pregnant by a 50-year-old nobody.
Wow.
That's what being your friend is like.
Damn. Spill that tea, girl.
I don't think she's sober.
I mean...
That's the.
I don't know if it's correct to do, but if I had to do one of those kind of interviews, I would try to loosen somebody up. Sorry, go ahead. Did you want to say something, Freeze?
You guys hear me? Yeah, I think he cut out. Oh. Yeah, I think because he was cutting in and out when he was talking.
He's in the Matrix.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how what influence she's under, but I was gonna have like an interview style, I would like to, you know, I'll have a drink or two just to loosen the person up.
I think don't you know when there's so much truth to something, it starts to sound crazy though.
That's true.
But I was gonna mention Orlando Brown and. It was somebody else that was out there, you know, what they say is spilling the tea. You know, when they talk like that, it just makes them sound nuts because it's nothing but truth. But I mean, again, it could be, you know, she's just a drunk ass lady who think hip hop is just evil. But I mean, Fair, you said, though, like, she haven't had any, you know, court documents, you know, come to her doorstep like, hey, we need you in court because you're defaming us.
Right. Yeah, but I mean, even like, because two reasons. One, if it is fake, then, no, I'm sorry, if it is real, then she would have to go to court and she would have to have proof and put out all the proof, right? I'm assuming. Mm-hmm.
If she's lying and she gets sued for defamation when the trial begins, yes, she would have to present evidence to the contrary that, right, that she's lying, which would be telling the truth. So here are my documents that back up my statements. And then the other side that is suing would have to present their evidence as to why she's lying.
And in either way, in either case, like a lot of whether
dirt gets put out there.
Tea,
yeah.
Yeah. A lot of tea yeah. will be spilled no matter
yes.
what.
Yes.
So it's probably, oh, don't hit nobody.
Uh-oh.
My bad. I thought I was going to be fucking ass.
Yeah, that's true. But yeah, either way, stuff is going to be put out there so the public can see, and they don't want a lot of questionable things out there. Even right. some of the things that I've heard her say about Will Smith and his son, like oh, yeah. crazy stuff. I'm like, wow, really?
For
and,
real,
and just like Marley said, like just hearing that come out of someone's mouth, you would think that they'd be crazy. But yeah. man, Hollywood in itself is a little crazy.
I mean, she started with this. She started with this, like before it became public with the whole Cassie situation, right? Mm. Where she brought her lawsuit. Jaguar had come out with her interview before that, and a lot of people when she first came out with that were thinking she was crazy because she was, you know, implicating Puff and Jay-Z and all these people. Then a couple months later, you know, the shit hits the fan.
Right.
But let me ask you this. This might be an unpopular question, but what would be the difference between her spilling all this so-called tea and what comes out of Kanye West's mouth?
I don't know.
I don't know. And that's the thing. And that's the thing I was saying, like, you know, even with Orlando Brown, you know, when he starts saying, you know, stuff that's been happening to him when he was, you know, when he was in the industry, you know, it's so much truth, it sounds crazy. So, I mean,
yeah.
I mean, Ye has been speaking some facts about these companies, and the shit has been hitting the fan with him, but a lot of people don't pay attention because he stir up so much shit, you never know what Kanye is really pinpointing on. So it's you never know with Ye.
And that's the difference.
At the same time,
they already think Orlando Brown and Kanye are crazy.
Yeah, it's pretty much out there. I don't know who Orlando Brown is, but what's up, Chill Will? Long time no see.
Orlando Brown is the kid from the Nickelodeon show.
Mm-hmm. That's already from Disney.
Mm.
But that's what the difference is, though. She's like talking, counting, collecting, and throwing stuff out there. But these guys are just all over the place, playing a whole bunch of different sides and look crazy. Orlando Brown supposedly was on crack on a couple of his interviews, and he's twitching all crackhead like. And Kanye West is just spewing shit out of his face. So they already labeled both of them, as crazy. So that's the difference.
Right. Shoving. Look at Cat Williams. Look at Cat Williams. Oh, man, this was the beginning of the year. It's like he was like, I would say he's the oracle, because my man was like, yo, 2024 is going to be one of those years.
Yep.
Shit, bro. Yep. Like the fucking hammer on a nail.
Yep. My man got it started.
And almost everything he's talked about has been in the tabloids.
Yeah.
But the same thing with him. They labeled him a crazy tinfoil hat wearing conspiracy whack job. Said he was on dope and he was out of his mind.
Joe Will, are you with us, my brother? You here?
I'm with you, bro. I was just waiting. I didn't want to kind of interrupt. What's up, big dog?
What's going on, brother? Long time no see. How you been?
Oh, you know, it's all good over this hood right here. What's happening, everybody? What's happening?
What up?
Yo.
We're just going through this latest video, I guess, with Jaguar, right? That's her name?
Mm-hmm.
And just, you know, having our two cents again put out there. I don't know that's if I have prophet. Enough time.
Jack Warren is through. A prophet. Right. No, you won't. You won't.
I probably won't have enough time to go through all of it, but I might do like an extra hour after this if anybody wants to throw in their two cents on the stuff. But right. Yeah, what you want to say about all this, Chill?
Oh man, I think somebody was saying it when I first walked in, when I came in. Like, somebody asked between the difference. You asked between the difference between her and Kanye. Kanye was probably feeling remorse because he probably is a Diddy type or Jay Z type. They're coming for Jay Z next for sure. They're coming for Jay. Well, yeah. He's smarter than Diddy. He's smarter than Diddy. So she mentioned that too, like in one of her interviews. He's just smarter than Diddy. Like. That's the reason why. But I don't know. They piss people off. And, you know, you can't get to that heights without doing fucked up shit. Like, I feel like that's a well-known. That's just like a well-known. You can't, especially in Hollywood. It's weirdos there. And so to get that high and not do weird shit or pedophilia or fuck your friends over. Man, you can go back. Like, they have several videos if you just listen to people. About how weird the rooms were or where the environment is to be able to scale the, you know, kind of like the ranks in those areas. So it's always been known, but it's just, I guess, social media is kind of making it more like, putting out there where you can hear more different people like Jaguar White that was amongst those people. She doesn't admonish her guilt and doing some of the crazy shit initially. But she is definitely outing everybody, and everything's coming to fruition. They try to call her crazy, but you know one thing: if they don't sue your ass for defamation or was it libel, then you know it's something. Like they called Meek Mill gay, and he just said, "You know, I'm sitting up in here with two girls right now. I love coochie." That's your response to
I
somebody.
It was gonna be media. Hard. It sucked.
What'd you say to me?
I thought it was
going to
be hard. It sucked.
Yeah, right. Whatever the case may be, they called Meek Mill gay. And he just came back with a tweet like, hey, I like Gucci. Like, that's like somebody call you gay in the media.
Like, what is
you
that?
Probably sue him. Like, your response is to sue their ass. Like, that's a lie.
Gucci.
I'm telling y'all, all these Gucci, rappers, Gucci, and shit, they're weirdos. These aren't like, they're rappers. They're not like thugs. 95% of these guys are guys maybe from the, they're rappers. They become, even Tupac himself, you can't go perform the art. He's a performer. He went to performing art school. He was never no thug. He ain't go to jail till he became a rapper. Like, these motherfuckers don't be who you think they is. They be weirdos. And they're great actors. Drake, great actor. He's a fucking Canadian, a Jewish Canadian. From fucking, like, that was raised by his Jewish family.
I said the same shit, bro. Like, man, is a fucking...
There ain't nothing wrong with that. It's just they're actors. They're actors. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's all it is. Entertainment. Mm-hmm. And you do weird shit to get there. And Jaguar Wright is definitely... There's no comparison between her and Kanye because Kanye is a fucking crazy... He's something psycho. And I mean, Cat Williams is cool. But something wrong with him too. But he's definitely more truthful than Kanye. But Jaguar Wright was amongst all of them coming up. Like all those guys. Like what she said about the Roots, Black Thought, Talib Kweli, like stalking her and being a weirdo. Like she got dirt on all of them. They didn't sue her for lying. They just said, you better watch your mouth.
Punk bitch. I ain't no punk bitch. I'm no punk bitch.
So and everything she's saying becoming the truth. So she right now she looking like she's pretty much untouchable. She's not Kanye for sure though. She's nothing like Kanye.
But then they say the people who talk the most insane is the ones that are really telling the truth though, because they speaking the truth.
I guess. But I don't think it's nothing. If you kind of know about the industry, because I know people that are in the industry that already told me about weird shit, and this was years ago. Like, people knew about R. Kelly 30 years ago. Literally. Yeah. People knew about Bill Cosby 35, 40 years ago. Like, people knew about, like, I mean, whether it's true or not, Michael Jackson, obviously. I mean, it's whatever. You know what I'm saying? However you feel. But they knew about, I mean, you can't be amongst all these predators. Or Quincy Jones. People knew about Quincy Jones so long ago. Clive Davis. People knew about him long ago.
Wait, what Puffy, about Quincy Puffy. Jones? What did I miss about Quincy Jones? Talk about that real quick. Just a little snippet. What about it's, Quincy Jones?
You have to go look it up because there's so much shit on him. Like okay, as far
okay,
as I,
okay.
How he did shit. Like he all that weird shit, all the pedophilia shit, the blood shit, and I don't know how much he evolved, but like all the weird shit in Hollywood,
like an evil rites of passage.
Or all yeah. the like the you know the homosexuality stuff,
demons.
Or just like overlord ruling type shit. Puffy did that. Puffy like blew up Kid Cudi card. Everybody knew that shit. Cause for talking to Cassie, he blew up his car. Like tried to kill him. Everybody knew Puffy. Like there's been plenty of accounts of just regular people saying, "Hey, this guy is stalking me. I can't prove it, but he's stalking me." And he's harassing me. The Kim Porter shit before she died. And there's a lot of people like, whether it's around Jay-Z or Puffy, they saying like how they come up missing or dying. Oh, it's just a coincidence. Maybe, maybe not. But overall, it's just a weird type of shit that's going on in those industries to where people of that power get there. And we don't even think, we don't even fathom that because we just listening to music, you know?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah, it's... It's some crazy, crazy stuff, bro. Let me just play a little bit more of this little talk.
You know what, Transrena? Oh God, no, we're not taking phone calls now. Hold on, what drive is this? Let me. Why is TJ calling me?
Oh, this gets more interesting
by the second.
This is Young and the Restless. This is like, this is Days of Our Lives.
Is H and Tony? Do y'all want to wait a minute? Let's talk to H and Tony.
Let's have a conversation. Let's go.
Sorry, I missed your call.
Oh,
so we need details, not this.
You know, when they call you, I hear the phone calls be recorded. You know, when you call back, they, you know, they be going up.
She's getting her recording.
Yeah, you got it. Okay, yeah. Yeah, let me call
she
back.
She needs content.
Right, let me call
ooh,
back.
On that's her. Interesting. That's interesting. Get your recording.
Sorry, I missed your call. Huh? Oh. Leave me a
it's always weird when you call somebody
why
and then you call right
call
back.
And then you call
and
back.
They don't answer
and
twice.
Don't
you just called me.
All right, so while they're setting this up, like that whole thing with like I don't know who this she's talking about. Where
Tasha K, she's like a podcaster. I think she's on YouTube. She does like live shows and stuff like that.
Okay, but the one part about getting a 50-year-old guy who has no money got you pregnant and mm-hmm. all that stuff, like.
That was Tasha K, and that was her. That was Jaguar explaining how good of a friend Tasha K is that she set up another friend with this 50-year-old dude, pretending he was a millionaire when he didn't really have much, and now she's pregnant with some broke ass wow. baby. And that's how good of a friend she is what she said.
That's shaky.
Yeah, that was all weird. You bloggers, on my God. Bond.
So, and again, speaking of bloggers,
it's time.
Jack, and we talked, so you spoke on the arrest.
Sorry, I missed your call.
Oh, now she's, that's the,
it's your name and your number.
And we're jumping around, because Sean Davyway asked, why is Jack calling me? So I want you to explain.
You
want
to call Sean Davyway and figure it out? Let's call Sean. Let's call
Yeah,
Adrian.
Let's see. He might be live. Right. He might be live right now. He might be live right
He'll
now.
He'll be live the second he sees my phone.
Like, Jack got a phone back?
Adrian.
Say, call him from North Tower.
I never made it to the tower.
Okay, see, that's let him know.
I was in crisis.
Right.
So I couldn't make any phone. Hello, Adrian. How are you, darling?
Hey,
it's Jacqueline.
Jackie. Oh, we're back to first name. We're back to that.
I mean, whatever. What's up?
What's up? How are you? You're free, I see.
I mean, I don't know. Am I? Tasha said I was never getting out.
No, no. I'm going to need you and Tasha to have a conversation.
I need Tasha to go eat a god. Like, I need Tasha to go and save her son from playing in monkey shit.
She said
the images are coming. He's in Tampa.
Oh my God.
Playing in monkey. Deep fakes are fabulous.
Fabulous.
So what's up? What do you wanna mediate, Adrian?
Well, what do you mean mediate?
That's what you're doing. You're trying to mediate.
You were not, well, no, I'm not trying to mediate. Now, don't get me wrong. I did try to see if it was a possibility of like you and Josh that ever talked.
Didn't I try that last year before she had me arrested?
Well, y'all did. And y'all, but y'all both were kind of like in agreement to like talk to each other.
She can talk to the devils that she's been dancing on.
Wow. I'm glad that they edited themselves so I don't have to worry about it.
You and she had to say about me in real life street stars. What beef? No. What beef does that weirdo? Yeah, no, listen to me. She has an issue with me, not with real life. They're content creators. What is her issue with them?
Well, I'm going to tell you what I think her issue is with real life. If she has one, she never told me she had a problem with them. But I think it's because you said certain stuff over on their platform about her.
Yeah, but you know, Jada Pinkett, you know, had a lot of stuff said about her with her and Belial on her platform. You know, I mean, this is the kind of that has her nose shoved up everybody's.
Somebody had to
but
do
see
it.
When somebody well, starts sniffing her,
Natasha.
Belial.
I thought y'all were cool.
I don't know what Belial. We are. He sat with that, but he told me the truth.
All right, so there's a lot of like name dropping of people that I don't really care about. Like, I don't know, are these all podcasters?
Belial's another singer. Belial's another singer. Tasha K that she was talking about is a podcaster. Yeah.
Okay.
Truth teller Tony, and told the truth.
Somebody's H Tony or somebody she mentions is another lady who helped her the first time she was in jail post bond. But I think she did her dirty. She stabbed her in the back. So she's talking, she talks crap about her as well. And that's who one of the people that calls her. And then when she tries calling back, they don't answer. She does that a couple times. And then there's another person she's talking to on the phone now, who I believe is some kind of online personality, content creator, where they're talking about Tasha K, who's another content creator. And so they're just kind of talking about Tasha K right now.
Okay.
And Tasha K's son, who apparently is playing in monkey shit. I don't know.
Yeah, that's the other interviewer's old boy from the Shade Room. He wanted to do those, the Shade Room interviews.
Yeah, I don't know who the interviewer is. Is it a newer interview? Like a more recent one?
Yeah, this is the last. This just released like last 24
yesterday,
hours.
I think.
I'm going to definitely watch this.
Okay, sure.
So this is the one where she just came out of prison.
So it might be timestamps. I know she was in prison, but it might be timestamps of people like in the video. So you might want to use those, Ralph. I don't know if it's a YouTube thing or anything, but a lot of times they're times. Because a lot of some of those people you won't know. They're kind of like.
That's true. Because I didn't think about that. Let me see if there is any timestamps in here. Because usually that stuff comes later if it's a just released. Just released
and she just like randomly talking. When she talk, they really just like randomly talking, and she'll just go off wherever. She's really like this. She's kind of chaotic, you know. As you can see, she's everywhere. She's probably like she's might be a fountain of truth right now for the right reason, but she's definitely probably a horrible date. she probably got some good coochie though. Probably horrible today.
You do.
Coochie, coochie, coochie. Told me his father coochie, did coochie, things coochie. To his son that he should be in jail for. Me and Storm discussed it. None of that showed up in the Tasha K interview. Don't sound like much of a tell-all to me.
So you just are wreak havoc, huh?
That is going to go down in flames. I love you, Adrian, but I'm in the middle of an interview. And I just want to tell you, congratulations. You're a real life street star.
Hey.
I thought it was going to be hard.
It's Mr.
And
David,
that's how it's done.
Yeah. You know, again, you call Davey Way and he brings up Tasha K.
Yeah.
And let's just jump right into it. You know, Tasha K pours up a full wine glass. Thankful that Jaguar Wright is where she needs to be.
She needed a gallon of wine. I need a shot of whiskey to kill you. Canadian whiskey. Hi, Aubrey.
So seriously, what is y'all doing whiskey?
Yeah, well, because she just said hi to Aubrey, a.k.a. Drake.
Oh.
I've been killed four times.
She's happy.
She stopped me 8 million. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let me see what I have in my recordings.
Oh, no.
Bones Coffee makes the most unique and delicious.
Sorry. So now we got to start worrying about people recording people, man. Oh, man. See,
that's what I'm saying, bro. It sounds like she just ambushed old boy she was on the phone with.
Gotta worry about people recording people. Is that one of your
right?
Hold on. First of all, this is a platform. And you guys know what you're getting into when you jump in. I'm talking about like going to someone's house.
I'm gonna be fair. Just to be
come
fair,
on over. Let's have some coffee.
I mean, just to be fair, I've been recording my baby mama for years.
That's a good one.
Like 2007 since the recording apps. You know, possible.
Yeah. Yeah, because you never know with that kind of situation.
Tell them it's in a policy, Ralph. It's in a policy. Yeah.
The fine print.
The fine print, bro. It's crazy. Okay.
No, it just sounded like she ambushed him, though, that was on the phone. Like, she didn't tell him he was on an interview until she was about to hang up.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I'm at an interview.
That's one thing
so.
That I don't understand. Oh, we're on a first-name basis now? Like, what does that mean?
Right. She was definitely ambushing.
I feel like you can sue her for that, too. Like, you're supposed to, like, ain't you supposed to tell people when they're being recording and put it out there like that?
Well, it depends on the state, so we'd have to check Texas and what their laws are, because I believe in Colorado, you don't. That? Yeah.
Okay. Well, I was thinking like YouTube, though. Like, if it's on YouTube, then that can cross states, right? I don't know the legalities behind it. I don't know shit, but, you know, I was just thinking like that's beyond just Colorado. That's not international, right? You put it on YouTube.
Yeah, correct, but I guess it depends on where it occurred. And if she's physically in the state where the two people are in the same state, then if that gets published,
I think this chick
that's
is
good
drunk.
Information. I did not.
Yeah.
But as long as one of you know that you're being that's recording, you're fine here.
But that's the point. He did know. He did know.
Yeah. So, Mama, baby, she did. Let me know. Damn it.
But she did.
I still wonder if I was ever recorded in my own home. By certain people.
Yeah, she knew they
got you on the couch, so. Mama Bear. Buns up. We got you on the couch. Buns up.
Oh, well. Hope you enjoy it. No. I wouldn't bounce record you, Ralph. Are
you
crazy?
You already on Pornhub and didn't know it.
Stop it. I wouldn't do that to you. Who the hell? Shut up, you guys. Fair use does it. He's an instigator. It's his laugh that gets you.
I've been instigating since this shit. Since my first day of school.
The beginning.
since
the beginning of time.
Oh, so you was the one who was like, oh, he said your mama was ugly.
Uh-huh. Yep.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Me and my good buddy of mine growing up, I knew him since first grade, and that's the type of shit we would do. We'd get bored and we would just start trouble between other people just so we can sit back and watch and just kind of see our chaos, you know, take form. It's great. It's a beautiful thing.
Loki and Thor. Loki and Thor.
If you have an issue, have a tissue.
Yeah.
That's the best thing when the two people having a conversation and you just be like, ooh, did she just, did she say you got purple hair? And then it's in front of everybody. And it only means you're like, the nails gonna
look. Yeah. Yep. Yep.
Yeah, that definitely was me. I definitely was that guy in the back in the club too. The club. Oh, that two women just have a slight disagreement. Ooh, she let your drink. She let the bartender take your drink. Ooh,
you can't do that now. People get shot.
Your kid is playing with money.
Yeah, you can't. You're right. Yeah.
It's a different time. It's a whole different time now.
Playing with monkey shit. Oh, man.
She did.
The fuck. Let's see what else is going on here, because we're going out of time right now.
I'm not sure which phone it's in. Babe, do you have my phone?
Because
my phone? Because I think it's in there.
Well, man, she sounds like a family member of mine. That's creepy.
Arch nemesis.
Well, no, she wants to be somebody. And now that she owes Cardi B money and can't mention her name anymore legally, she chose me.
Oh,
yeah. That's what she does. She rides, you know, like a leech. Or better yet, a barnacle.
She said she was proud to get your family on her platform.
Oh, I know.
To talk.
Which is interesting because she couldn't have done it without me because I gave her all of their phone numbers, including my ex-husband. One.
Well, there you go.
Even your expose on May was produced by May.
Somebody had to do it.
Okay. And she also mentioned with her interview with Sean David Way, she said, I made Grant Jaguar the time to go back and forth with her.
Grant?
That's word she used.
She's a nobody. She's a nobody that owes a relevant somebody $4 million and can't pay.
I am the chosen one.
She's a nobody that does comedy shows that she has to pay people to attend.
Bitch.
She's a nobody that sent her child to Africa to go play with monkeys, giraffes, and elephants.
I'm positive.
You don't sound very confident.
And as you pull that up, Jack, I'm just curious.
Yeah.
I'm going to go back to the whole arrest part.
Mm-hmm.
Do the police know who you are when they pull you up?
Of course they do.
As you get entered into, let me tell you, I want to tell you something. Yeah. I got a call from my police friend who's been on this couch before. Shout out Larry Bankston.
Oh, wow.
He said, hey, I just seen, he don't want to say my name because he's like, yeah. I seen one of your talents come through here by somebody. So you're so known that the police let the other police know we got this person.
Yeah.
How is it when they're walking you through? Because Dallas is like your second home now. Yeah. How is it? Do people like notice you off the rip?
Oh, no. Do they show you? I found out that you guys released the Gene Deal interview
when I was getting released.
Oh,
get somebody, that's Jaguar. Yo, Jake, I seen the new interview. Yo, I said, did you see me and G? I seen G. Yo, it's crazy. Oh. Real life. While I'm being released, we walk out. And while we're looking for the car, someone asked for a picture.
God.
Odell said no. They was like, yo, Jack, that's Jack.
Wow.
In jail. So, yeah, I'm me everywhere I go.
Dallas needs a TMZ. Do they put you with everyone or they put you
protective? I was in protective custody. Actually, not protective custody. I was put in crisis.
Ooh.
Even in protective custody, you can make a phone call if you need to. But see, in crisis, in the suicide ward, there's no communication. No phone, no nothing. No privileges, no nothing.
Welcome to my world. Shout out, Ange.
So, all that being said, yeah, no. After I told everybody about how I had footage of the DA having sex at 29 years of age at a Clinton fundraiser here in Dallas.
Ooh, got him.
With a 14.
Commence your journey with 52 Creative Code, where every piece is a celebration of Colorado.
Explore our unique handcrafted collections today. Visit 5280creativeco.com. Craving a crunch? Dive into the world of Prowler Pickles for that perfect pickle punch. Order now at prowlerpickles.com and taste the craft of Colorado. Bracken's Firearms Co., your destination for quality and reliability. Explore our selection of firearms at affordable prices. Visit BrackensFirearmsYahoo.com or call 719-465-8320 today. Finally, relax with Kiss My Fist Medco. Discover the finest CBD products designed for your wellness. Visit KissMyFistMedco.com today and find your balance.
Start your mornings off by tuning into Coffee with RW on WESN Epic Strategies Network. Download our mobile app and check out our website, EpicStrategiesNetwork.com. Sorry, I had to do it. Okay, 14-year-old what?
Yeah.
14-year-old girl that's now a grown woman who they have in the state psych hospital, so none of her evidence has to go on record. They started getting a little touchy.
Ooh.
And then when I started reminding them that I still had a list of all of the guards who had sex with prisoners for my...
Ooh, wow. Hold on.
Mm-hmm.
Guard! Yep. Guard! Guards! Wow. So wait, she said that since someone is in a psych ward, like evidence doesn't get used or looked at? Is that what she was trying to say? I don't know.
I think when someone gets put into that type of situation when they're like in a psych ward, I think they're not in charge of their own care, whereas someone else is in charge of their care, i.e. the facility or the doctor. And so they're the ones that would be making decisions on behalf of that person because they're quote unquote not well or not of sound mind and body.
This is how it starts, so they can destroy your character if they ever were to go to court.
That's a good point.
Yep, because you're crazy. You're crazy. Look, you've been crazy. Like, nobody's going to believe it. Right.
All right, so I just got the 2-minute warning. We're going to let it end. I'll come back. We'll do a little more, another hour powwow and all that stuff. And then check out the Mama Bear Tracy show on WESN at 1 p.m. Eastern time. Go check it out.
There's a special guest on there.
And there's a special guest on there?
All right. There is.
I'm down with that. That's awesome. Uh-huh. See, I don't even know what's going on the show. So check that out at 1 p.m., but we'll come back. I'm going to get a cup of coffee because this seems like it's going to be interesting, the rest of this conversation. And you guys can join. I might do this a private one. So I'll throw someone will throw the link on the Discord. If you're on Discord, then you'll get it. You can hop in. Chill Will, are you on Discord still? Is he even here?
Yeah, bro. I might be. I don't know. Might not be so booty nowadays. I might be. I just don't remember the service.
Are you still on Instagram?
Yeah, for sure.
All right, so we'll throw you the link on Instagram, and if everybody wants to come back and continue the conversation, I'm gonna make that talk private, and that's gonna be for Patreon.